guy told me that maybe I can go to his boat. Maybe they have someone for the crew, but it's not sure. So if he's not, then I can go. And the guy's name is Mark. He's from Australia, and I'm going to go back tomorrow at 8 o'clock. And we'll see. I hope the best. But never forget, if your desire closest to you, it's near. I started to feel interesting because I started to feel that I want to be home, but not just to be home, just I want to live in a better way, I want to travel in a better way, not like this. At home everything is just so easy. If you want to wash your clothes or you want to take a shower, you can do it. If you want to do it here, you need to walk for hours. So I feel that there is something in me which just want to break out, maybe cry, or I don't know, but really interesting feeling. This is funny. I came here to 8 o'clock, before 8 o'clock, around 15 minutes, because of that boat. And I met here with Carol and Claudia. They told me yesterday that they are going to leave today. And we met on the same place. The captain came for them. We went in. He was walking. And I saw that, wow, they are next to my boat. And I was looking for the number. And I saw that. No, it's not next to my boat. It was the boat where they told me that let's come back, and if the other people are not good, then I can go with them. And it's their boat. Someone just told me that they are leaving soon to Egypt, but after they come back on the 2nd of November, and if I don't find a boat till that time, then they can help me. So the good news, I won't stay here longer than November. The airport. Little bit of marketing. So I just wanted to put some advertisement here when I came, and he told me that he's the manager of this place, so he will put down all my papers, so it's not the best idea, but I left 3 papers in the office. So I just went in all of the shops, mostly restaurants, and I left there one paper everywhere. Everybody left me to leave there. One girl is going to ask her boss in this place. They told me that it's not a good idea to leave here because here aren't captains, just gamblers. Oh no, I just got my first no. Here lives a really great guy who lives here in Gibraltar, and he told me that he has a cave, so I just asked him to show it to me, and it's really amazing. He lives here. Amazing. This cave. Nice. This was really great. I went to a boat and there were two guys, the captain and another guy, a crew member, and they told me that we get to the boat. I didn't even ask what I want. And we started a conversation. They told me that they go to a Portuguese island, then to the Canary Islands. Actually, it's a boat where people learn how to sail, and the crew is going to change, and the captain told me that he's going to call the owner of the boat and ask her if I can join. And it was really great because I was there for a half an hour. We were chatting, there were other guys too. It was really great. It was really great feeling. Sit on the boat. This is the first time. It was amazing. Yesterday evening when I went to my tent, a Spanish man, a fisherman, told me that police was there, and they told that I can sleep there at night, but if I am there at the daytime, then they will clean my tent from there, if I understood it correctly. So I packed my stuff, I have it with me. I don't know yet where I am going to sleep. And I come back to La Linea, to the port. And my plan is to be here all day, hitchhiking boats, because today is no Nazareth, no library. Hi guys, should I cross or what?
He doesn't like it. He's on the run from the police, man.
Yeah, exactly. I'm terrorist. Yeah.
That's kind of police.
By the way, man, where is your GoPro? Always you have here.